We wrap it up last game with Edmonton, San Jose, 17-18. San Jose minus 145, total 5.5. Edmonton Oilers, one thing I will say is this team, even though they're way out of it, they know it. Everybody knows it. Playing hard, you know, over the last few games. I'll give them that. They are. I mean, they haven't, waved the white flag. The effort hasn't really waned. They're still sloppy in their own zone. They're still turning the puck over. They're still under siege a lot of times in their own end. That's a little bit of a concern for me. You look at it, the last game against Anaheim. Anaheim was swarming Edmonton's net that entire third period. Finally got the game tied. Finally got it to overtime and a shootout where Edmonton is able to prevail. But again, shootout's a coin flip, could go either way. 6-5, you look at the last four games for Edmonton, allowed 45, 30, 33, and 46 shots on goal. So seems like Todd McClellan has basically said, hey, we're not going anywhere. Roll the puck out there. Let's go up and down. Let's give up a lot of chances. Let's try to get a lot of chances. Let's score some goals. Let's have some fun. Or try to have some fun, as much fun as we can, despite a moribund, dismal season that it's been. So for me, Edmonton's looking like an over team right now. I'd be very reluctant to bet them under right now. They're just giving up way too many chances, way too many shots, and they're also getting way too many shots. They've eclipsed 40 shots on goal in two of their last three games, including that Anaheim game. And that's a good Anaheim defensive team. And they put up 42 shots, 6-5 final score. So for me, I'd go over 5.5 here in this game. That's the only way I'd go. Problem is, it's not a game I love. It's a lean only because it's a situation where, San Jose, we know how good defensively they are. They're an undertrending team. They're back home off a four-game road trip. So for me, lean over. Still got to decide if I pull the trigger, though, on that one. I'll do some more reading on it. But lean for me over the total. Dana Lane's involved. Edmonton, San Jose. Dana, what do you got?
Well, I don't usually love to go in on teams that just got through making major picking on major players, as San Jose did with Patrick Kane. But I kind of, when I think of how happy Patrick Kane is to be out of Buffalo, it's kind of equated to the first time I took my dog to the dog park and I just let him go and he's running around. He's so happy. I mean, this is the way I view that Kane is going to be for San Jose. Now, I don't know whether or not, he just got out there. He got signed yesterday, so I assume he's going to be playing tonight. I've been trying to figure out whether or not he's going to be available for this game. Maybe you guys know that or not, but either way, I still think San Jose is the better of the two teams. If Kane does play, I mean, he's a guy that's a 25-30 guy. If he stays healthy, he's impactful. And this is a Sharks team that's lost three straight. They trail Vegas by 8 points in the Pacific Division. Vegas also owns a game in hand. So these are the type of games that the San Jose Sharks cannot afford to lose. Goaltending wise, if Martin Jones starts today, I'll be getting a netminder and a team that's in a revenge spot. They dropped the 5-3 decision in mid-December. And Jones has dropped two of the last three meetings against Edmonton at the SAP Center. So I assume that, San Jose is going to be extremely focused to get this W tonight. And even though Edmonton is a team that when I've seen Edmonton live, they're as fast and as quick as any team that I've seen this year. And it's still perplexing to me why it is that they're struggling so much. And to me, it's got to be between the ears. And like I said to you the other day, I mean, I've talked to people in that organization and it's basically, man, when they play teams that interest them or engages them, that's when they're at their best. So I know that they have it in them, but I don't think this is going to be, I think the team that's going to be engaged tonight is the San Jose Sharks. Of course, Patrick Maroon's going to be out of the lineup for Edmonton after getting traded to New Jersey. He was a guy as of late that had played on their top line with Dreisaitl and McDavid. And now they put Lucic in that spot. And I just don't think Lucic is a top line winger at this point. And I think that they're going to have some cohesive issues there. Tom McClellan, of course, I mean, it's not, not stable, but McClellan has mixed his lines up quite a bit. So I think he's trying to find the right combination. They have scored more as of late, but as we know, San Jose is definitely one of the top defensive teams in the league. They really need this game tonight, and I expect a focused effort from the Sharks against the Oilers tonight.
All right, San Jose minus 145 for Dana. Yeah, between the years, and there's no defenseman outside of Sekera and maybe Larson that I trust on this team. That's a big part of it. Alex B. Smith, we're getting the hook, so very quickly, Edmonton, San Jose for you.
Okay, well, this is actually a best bet play of mine, so if you want to wait and just roll into that.
All right, best bets. Alex, go.
Okay, all right, so yeah, I'm on the Edmonton Oilers here, and I had to correct you, Dana. It's Evander Kane that is in San Jose, not no. Patrick Kane. I would have lost my head if Patrick Kane had gotten traded yesterday. But, yeah, so Evander Kane in San Jose. But this Edmonton team, and Ian, you made a great point. I think now that the trade deadline has passed and they're you know, over, everybody knows that they're staying in Edmonton for the rest of the year. I think they're going to be playing a lot more looser, a lot more kind of fire wagon freestyle hockey. And I think they're going to be relaxed now, as opposed to where you look at San Jose. Yes, this is a must-win game. These are important points. They'll be the team that'll be gripping their sticks a little bit tighter, you know, trying to be a bit more focused, obviously. But once again, and we've talked about this for years, Sharks coming back home off of a road trip of four more games, not always the best spot for them. Edmonton has won 8 of the last 11 meetings with San Jose. I think they'll be the more relaxed team coming in. I think they should be able to get the win. I think it's a decent price. So I'm looking at Edmonton tonight, and that is my best bet.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to our channel. Now we've put a lot of work into producing all these free videos, so please help us out and keep all our content free for you forever by simply liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Now, not to mention, a visit to our industry-leading website will warm the hearts of all our SBR employees, especially myself. Now, the links are over there to the left, so do check those out. Thanks for watching.